Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, we are going to start the final accounts, guys. Guys, totally this whole lecture I'm dividing into four different videos, guys. In the first video, we'll be going through about trading account, and after that, we'll be going through profit and loss account. After that, balance account, balance sheet. So these three combination, like we'll be doing first step, second step, third step. This complete steps will be, if we combine, then we will be finding the final account, guys. So I'll be discussing this whole topics in four lectures. So please watch them in series, guys. Please don't mix them or don't watch directly the fourth lecture, because you will be having huge confusions if you directly watch the final account problem. So first, let us go through trading account first in this lecture. Okay. So let us start. So basically trading account. So if you want to have a formula or anything, you can learn this, guys. But I will be just saying you with the help of the table. Don't worry. Okay. So first, what is trading account, guys? So trading account, the thing, once you remember the trading account, so T means, remember that T means D, guys. So TD are friends. So let us assume a guy name with T and D, guys. Okay. So T and D are friends or anything. Please remember the two words. So once you identify the name trading, it means the direct expenses. Okay. So please remember that. In next lecture, we'll be going through profit and loss, which deals with indirect expenses, guys. So that's the reason why I'm saying you the differences first itself. So you'll be identifying it. So trading account is prepared essentially to find the gross profit and the loss of a firm where the gross profit is exceeded. To find gross profit and gross loss, we'll be using this, guys. So once we are going through the problem, you'll be having a clear idea, guys. Don't worry. Okay. So the given problem will be in this way. Prepare a trade and profit. Okay. Here we are discussing only about trade account. Okay. So prepare a trade account in the books of XYZ company for the year 2015. So he gave the opening stock as 2 lakhs, closing stock as 3 lakhs and purchases as 2 lakhs, sales as 6 lakhs, purchase returns as 5 lakhs, wages as 40,000, carriage inwards as 20,000. Okay. And sales returns as 30,000 and factory electrical bills 10,000 and power and fuel 30,000. So the thing that you will be doing here is you will be separating them, guys, like into four different parts. Direct expenses, what are the purchases, opening stock and sales. So these are the four divisions that I till now found the major things that are repeated, guys. So if possible, I'll be just writing, like in our previous lecture, we discussed about trial balance, right? Like that, I'll be trying to write for this also, guys, so that we can just remember it and we can do it really faster. Okay. So the first thing we'll be doing here is we'll be drawing the pro forma again, date, particulars, two times amount, because we'll be adding or subtracting few amounts. So better to write two amount columns and date, particulars, two amount columns. Okay. So the first thing that you will be doing is on this side, you'll be having the opening stock, purchases, purchase returns, and the direct expenses. Fine, till here you will be having, guys. On the other side, you will be having the sales and the closing stock. Here opening stock and here closing stock, purchases, sales, direct expenses. So I hope everyone got at least a small idea on this. So let me turn the paper and let us think about what are these things. So opening stock, I told you, opening stock will be on the left side, closing stock on the right side. So let us assume I have just written them right now. So opening stock, closing stock, fine. Okay. So further moving on, purchases. So I told you purchases will be on the left side. So purchases with a pair of purchase returns. So you purchase something and you have returned them. So you got the cash back. So indirectly the amount that you get, that you will be giving, is nothing but 1,50,000. So that's what I have just written here. Two purchases, 2 lakhs, and we have to decrement the purchase return. So 50,000 becomes 1,50,000. Okay. So now we are done with this purchases. So now let us go through sales also. Sales is a combination with sales returns. Okay. So sales and sales returns. So we'll subtracting it, 6 lakhs minus 30,000. It is 5,70,000, I think. So yeah, 5,70,000. So that's what we will be writing here. Buy sales 6 lakhs, buy sales returns 30,000. That is nothing but 5,70,000. Fine. So now we are done with almost everything, guys. So the left out things like wages. Wages will be your direct expenses. So you may ask me that what are these indirect and direct? How can I justify? So basically there will be a lengthy question in this way, guys. The final account will be in this way. So see here. So here they are given a list of things, right? So this question will be asked mostly for 10 marks or even in one paper, I think it's given for 15 marks, guys. So that is the reason why you need to learn it perfectly. So basically, the direct expenses are nothing but the money that you spent while creating or while manufacturing your particular object, like daily labor, like transportation charges of the raw materials, or any kind of factory billing, factory lighting, factory any kind of things like that. So here I have took only those things here, so that will be clear for you. So wages. Wages are nothing but when you are creating object, you will be giving salary. It's not called as salary, guys. Salary means it will be coming under indirect expense. Salary will be given for monthly or yearly, whereas wages will be given for daily. Okay, so carriage inwards is nothing but this also comes under the direct expenses. And factory electrical billing is also direct expenses. And power and fuel will also be direct expenses. So all direct expenses on your left side. So we have just updated the table according to whatever I have told. We have updated the table. So we are done till here, guys. Okay. So now you will be calculating the total of the right side, guys. So 5 lakhs plus 3 lakhs, we got 8,70,000. So that's what I have just written here. So this minus this. So if you get the positive value, that will be your gross profit, guys. If you get the negative value, that will be your gross loss. That's what I have just written in the previous paper, the formulas. So if you want, you can read the formulas or practice the formulas, or you can just do it with the help of the table. So just by subtracting this, you will be getting the gross profit carried down. So we got 4,20,000. So that is also again carried down. Fine. So once we are done till here, so we are done with only 1/3 of the problem, guys. When you consider the whole final account. So this is the 1/3 part. So I hope everyone is now clear with it. So if you have any problems or examples in your classwork or anywhere, please try them, guys, once. Okay. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through the profit and loss account, guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.